this is me leaving Atlanta. To be honest, it's not something I usually do. I'm from Atlanta, and being a busy Georgia Tech student doesn't help much either. There was a little girl sitting next to me on this flight, the first of many flights, trains, buses, and ferries. It was her first time flying, and she was nervous, she told me. I used to be nervous flying, I told her. I used to. They told me I had to make a project about border crossing. Well, here it is. A story about how all of us, used to. We're different because we decided to take that leap across the U.S., across the Pacific, and experience something we've never experienced before. Despite our fears, despite our worries, thanks to or in spite of our parents, cell phones and social lives asleep for 3 months, bags packed, a few things forgotten at home, a few things extra we could have left behind. But not everyone packs up their lives into 23-kilogram bags and leaves their only home, the only continent they know, no less. But these brave souls did. And this is their story.
I'm Drew Smith.
Hi, my name is Lauren Traxler.
Hi, my name is Cole Rutkowski.
Hey, I'm Dustin Watts.
Hi, my name is Julian Garuba.
Hi, my name is Barrett Ehlers.
What's up, Ethan Hayes, how's it going?
Hi, my name is Lauren Byron.
What's up, guys? I'm Kevin Driscoll.
Hi, I'm Kathy Wasugi.
Hi, my name is Sean Sullivan.
Hi, my name is Alana Martin.
Hi, I'm Monique Chan.
Hi, I'm Michael Vredeveld.
Hi, I'm Blair Naples.
Hey, my name is Shelby Hasberger.
I'm Allison Miles.
I'm Shirley.
My name is Alberto Gonzalez.
My name is Vincent Fry.
Hello, all. My name is David Estrada.
Hi, I'm Charles Anthony Albo.
Hi, my name is William Abernathy.
Hi, I'm Jacob Lestrange.
Hi, I'm Morgan.
Hi, my name is Andrew Crumry.
Hi, my name is Gregory Wetter.
Hi, I'm Josh Vaughn.
I came to Australia, New Zealand.
Pacific program, one, because I've always loved Australia and New Zealand ever since I was a little kid, and because my parents paid for it.
I went on the Pacific program. I felt like of all study abroad programs, these are the countries that I wanted to go to the most, and I felt like study abroad was something I definitely wanted to do, and I really like the fact that they're English-speaking countries, they have tropical climates, and I got to go have summer during the winter. It was really cool, and yeah, so... That's
why I am on the Pacific program to do crazy shit that my parents won't find out about until I get home.
I'm on the Pacific program because ever since I got my diving certification, I really wanted to dive on the Great Barrier Reef. And I know a lot of people down from Australia and New Zealand, and they've always talked to me about it, and I wanted to come.
I'm a biology major, you see. I love to travel.
You know, I do this program because I like the outdoors. I love, you know, being in the water. I've always been interested in, you know, New Zealand and Australia cultures. And really, I didn't really want to go to another country where they speak a different language. So, you know, all those things and, you know, just the adventure of it all.
I am on the Pacific program because I wanted a study abroad where I could really do something I love and enjoy. And I love all sorts of water sports, snorkeling and diving, and is fantastic for both of those.
I wanted the Pacific program because I wanted to study abroad. I wanted to kind of get out and see something new, get out of the U.S., especially away from Georgia Tech. And I thought this would be a lot of fun, be really adventurous. And I also don't speak any languages, so this was one of the best programs for me to do.
I wanted to see a different part of the world, man.
What's been the biggest adjustment for you living in Australia and New Zealand? What's been like scary or worrisome or just a challenge for you while you've been here?
The biggest adjustment with living in Australia and New Zealand is being away from my family and not really exactly knowing how long I've been away, because while you're here, I feel like time isn't measured in time, like hours or days. It's kind of measured in experiences.
Well, there's not a lot of cops. I haven't seen a lot of cops. Not that I'm worried about the locals, but it just seems like there's less enforcement around.
The biggest adjustment has been the cost of things and just how much more it is relative to the US.
I'd say the biggest challenge I had to make was balancing both studies and exploring the nations I've been in.
Just being away from home, I guess, because I've never really been that far and for that long away from Johns Creek, Georgia. And I didn't know anyone on this trip, and it was kind of nerve-wracking at the beginning.
The biggest adjustment must have been moving around a lot, just settling into a place and then moving away, getting to know a place and then just leaving it behind.
What's your favorite thing you've done so far?
Bungee jumping, skydiving, or this right here, going to Milford Sound.
We all went skydiving yesterday.
Skydiving.
Definitely skydiving in Taupo.
Yeah, what was that like?
That was amazing, nothing like I've ever done.
Just kind of seeing the landscapes and everything, like seeing what's so different about New Zealand.
Diving.
Heron Island, actually.
That would definitely be the Waitomo Caves.
Favorite thing I've done so far, hands down, is the glowworms tour. Loved abseiling down into that cave.
I think the coolest thing I've done so far is caving in the Waitomo Caves, just seeing the glowworms just swimming around in really cold water.
Blackwater caving, and then the Australia Zoo is cool.
The Black Cave water rafting. That's something I would never do anywhere else.
You mean the Blackwater cave?
Blackwater cave rafting.
Okay.
Some combination of black cave water rafting.
The other day at lunch, I talked to some Maori guys, and one of them, his dad, is going to commission a tiki for me.
I think my favorite thing was the whole South Island experience, going to Queenstown and Milford Sound.
I slept on a boat in Milford Sound overnight.
Yeah, how was that?
It was epic. It was amazing. Milford Sound is just magnificent.
Kayaking in Milford Sound.
That's a good question. I would say, yeah, pass.
All right, well, Josh, any last words you have for us?
Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Don't what?
Don't do anything I wouldn't do, which isn't much.
Last words are for men who need to finish what they said.
Whoever is out there, enjoy yourself. Have fun. Enjoy the view.
G'day, mate.
Hi, Mom.
Yes, Pacific program!
Bring a rope and have fun. This cheesy cliche, live life and enjoy it.